Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and we're going to talk about low angle cases today and masseters. And why me as an orthodontist, I have really good eyes for catching gotchas, catching cases that might be trickier than you think. And if you've worked with me on an orthodontic case before, it's one of the first things I look at. Why do we, sometimes I get doctors who only take screenshots and they're showing me their patients' pictures from screenshots from the scan. And like, no, I need to see extra oral photos. There's so many things I look at in an extra oral photo. I'm looking at the shape of your face. I'm looking to see if there's symmetry. I'm looking at your masseter muscles. It's one of the main things I look at. And this is a great image here of this patient has some pretty bulky masseter muscles. Matter of fact, I can just see them. Can you see them right here? And there's a way that you can measure your masseters. And if you want to know more about masseter muscles, definitely check out the other content I've made on the subject. You can go to my YouTube channel to go there. Go to your YouTube channel. Put in the search bar at the top, Straight Smile Solutions. That'll take you to my YouTube channel, which has a green banner. From there, there's a tiny magnifying glass towards the top right. You can put in masseter or Botox. And that'll take you to my other videos on administering masseter Botox and all kind of things like that. And how to measure. But this is actually when, if you ever had masseter Botox, or if you go to a day spa, and there's a lot of dentists that do it too. Personally, I think all dentists should be doing it because it's incredible pain relief. It also can help to shape your face. If you have a very square or boxy face, it's huge in Korea. They do this all the time. And this is actually how I learned to do it. I learned it from a Korean physician who does a lot of aesthetic sculpting. So really slims your face, really cool stuff. But if you don't want to slim your face, you can lower the dose just to help with the symptomatic with the masseter pain or the jaw joint pain. But this will really, really help. Now, what will happen if you took an orthodontic case in a patient like this? Well, you might have some really unpredictable results if the patient is doing aligners. Why? Because if you have really, really chunky, thick, bulky masseters that are like three fingers thick, you will get likely a lot of clenching from that muscle force on the plastic. The clenching on the muscle force, especially during the day and at night, can cause intrusion or a posterior open bite. Now, that's all okay if you have Invisalign because I can build anterior bite turbos into the case and not be worried about it. But on other aligner systems that don't offer that feature, it turns into a train wreck. As a matter of fact, a lot of doctors that I worked with, and you may be one if you're listening to this, there's sometimes where the posterior open bite gets so severe that we have to switch the case from ClearCorrect to Invisalign. Now they do offer anterior bite turbos, but they don't call them that. They call them engagers on the lingual or the palatal of 7 through 10. And it's really difficult to get them. And they're not quite the right thickness and they don't quite work as well because they're just basically engagers. And they're like, at least Invisalign, when I ask for anterior bite turbos, they measure them, they do the right shape. It's just not quite the same thing. So I really strongly recommend on your low angle cases or your deep bite cases that you do not use ClearCorrect and many other aligner systems. I don't even remember who has them, who doesn't. I think Reveal has them. SureSmile might have them. Definitely the white label company that I use has them and they do a great job with them. So think about your case before you just throw it to ClearCorrect, because until they fix this whole anterior bite turbo problem, there's going to be a lot of issues with their cases and it's going to be a struggle. And personally, in my opinion, if they took that case and a major posterior open bite developed, you need to call and complain and get your money back on that case. And I've had many doctors who have gotten it. They don't get the cash back, but they'll get a credit for another case. So you have to fight that one a little bit. If the bite got screwed up, they'll say you can fix it by adding posterior engagers and doing a lot of extrusion, but that's not the right way to do it because you're not attacking the problem at its source. So if you really have to stick with ClearCorrect, then I recommend sending your patient to the esthetician or doing it in your office, just loading them up with masseter Botox. Keep in mind that the price point is well around $1,000 for one of these doses. So it's not cheap because it's a heck of a lot of Botox that they have to use. And Botox is sold per unit. I think when they do mine, it's 30, 40 units per side, which is easily where I live, close to $1,000. Some places like Texas might be cheaper. So, phew, just wanted to let you know all that. Definitely consider it and take a look at your cases a little more carefully in terms of the shape of their face. All right, thanks so much.